Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing. I'm on it. Hello? Anyone here?
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier. For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned. Damn. I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again. An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
The lights are on! Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing! Have fun!
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Alice? Honey?
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan?
Just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Damn it.
Alice?
Alice!
Alice, no! No!
Alice!
gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right!
What the hell?
Oh, no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Among Alice's things was a book. The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please! I've been in an accident! Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident! I need help!
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Where?
figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
During your trying, it's the latest thing in
yes.
Customly.
Right fall station. Oh,
let you.
Hello?
Two.
Hello?
One stone. You can see the
spirit. The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out. There were more of them. I never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station. I saw the river below. Something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water. Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me. Taken. They're taken. hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it. The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site. Thank you.
was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive. I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV. Talking crazy. Was I losing my mind? The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Ball Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Candy-colored clown they call the Sandman tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I